Yo, what's going on, y'all? It's Combo Breaker 99. I'm back with another post-fight analysis video. All right, y'all, Kanako Murata versus Vernon Jandiroba. I knew this fight wasn't going to go the distance. Like I said, too much explosiveness, too much recklessness, and great ground attacks from both fighters and stand-up attacks that just spell finish. You know, Jandiroba, she didn't get the submission in the fashion I thought she would, but the stoppage, the TKO in the second round, was from a grueling armbar in the first round that Murata survived. So we'll talk about that more at the end. But yeah, overall, man, it was just one of those explosive fights where I said, they just got too much going for them, and there's just too many explosive attacks from both fighters where I knew that this wasn't going to go the distance. But yeah, man, looking back at the first round, right away, we got both strawweights wanting to strike, which I figured, you know, Jandiroba was putting that right hand to work. She cracked Murata once, knocking her back, buzzed her with another and another, and I was like, uh-oh, she's putting that pressure on, and she's landing big right hands consecutively. I was like, uh-oh, somebody's about to get stopped. And these are the holes that I mentioned in Murata striking. You know, she bounces back and forth, but she's still standing right in front of you. So all you have to do is have a good straight right hand or a good loopy right hand and some technique behind it. And Jandiroba, she's much more fluid on her feet, and her right hands are very calculated. Murata, she's feigning. She's using these little, you know, herky-jerky movements, but it's not there's no timing behind it. She's not really timing to try to switch levels on Jandiroba. So Jandiroba, she's getting comfortable on her feet. And Jandiroba, she punches her way into a clinch. And Murata, she pressed Jandiroba to the cage and landed some good knees. But Jandiroba, she pulls guard, gets down on her back, and she goes for that armbar, like I said, because Murata, when she's in that guard, she gets reckless. And even with her ground and pound that she was trying to land, you know, she's bringing her whole body up. And as she comes down, Jandiroba could kind of raise that guard higher and go straight for the armbar. So she went for one armbar attempt, and Murata was able to escape. Second armbar attempt, Jandiroba, she goes belly down, and she locks the arm. But Murata, she holds on, which you can tell is a painful position. And if she doesn't tap, some damage will come. You can see, because Jandiroba's not letting go. And Jandiroba, she spins over till she's on her back again. And finally, Murata breaks free. But you can see that the way she was pulling that arm and the way she was able to spin with it and maneuver, she was doing damage to that arm. I mean, this round, Murata finished on top, but she didn't really get much in. Just a few elbows, but she really couldn't get any leverage to land anything big. And also, if you go back and look at the five-second mark, look at the five-second mark in this round. When Murata's on top and Jandiroba controls the wrist of Murata, if you look at her left arm, you can see the elbow of Murata kind of hyperextend. It kind of bends inward whenever she grabs it and she kind of leans forward. So Jandiroba's trying to hold that wrist. She's controlling it, but Murata's coming forward. So as she comes forward, you can kind of see it bend in. So go back and look at it. I don't know if that was the moment where it damaged, or that was just to show that that was just a part of the damage that resulted in from the armbar that took place. So the armbar probably did do the damage though. But going back and looking at the second round, Jandiroba, she was just controlling the distance well from here, you know, making Murata circle in her direction that she wanted. She was circling to her left, going right into those head kicks and those right hands. Murata also at this point was just half defenseless. If you look at that left arm, it was hanging low. It was completely useless as Jandiroba lands a big head kick. You know, Murata, she's shooting for a takedown, but without the left arm, she can't get it. So Murata at this point, she's in survival mode. You know, she's not able to get anything off. And I'm wondering why the ref hasn't caught on like I have and maybe other fans and just tried to stop this thing. But Jandiroba, at this point, she's just teeing off. She's landing her strikes, landing that beautiful looping right hand. Like I said, Jandiroba's right hand was going to be key in this fight. She throws it with technique, either straight or overhand. It's going to be effective. Jandiroba, she pretty much dominated the round with her stand-up because of a lack of Murata's left arm. But I think Jandiroba would have done the same even if her arm wasn't damaged. You know, even if Murata's arm wasn't damaged, I think she would have dominated on the feet because she was just much more polished with her strike and just powerful. You know, she looked more powerful with her right hands and her jabs in those head kicks. Yeah, like I said, regardless, I think she would have won the stand-up battle anyway. But after the second round, referee steps in, stops the fight. You know, that's it. They say that's it. I think we can pretty much say that Vernon Jandiroba won via armbar because since Murata didn't submit, she suffered damage to the left arm, which hindered her performance, right? But yeah, this was a solid fight. It was a great showing by Vernon Jandiroba. I had to go with Jandiroba because I knew she had the jujitsu to deal with the reckless moments on the ground of Murata. You know, Murata is strong, but in my opinion, her level of striking and timing is still not on that elite level. It's still not on that level of like a Carla Esparza. That's why I say Carla has better striking and better timing because she knows how to circle and shoot in for her takedowns kind of offbeat. She shoots in offbeat and she has good timing. You know, she knows how to switch levels on a jiu-jitsu practitioner like Vernon Jandiroba, and just overall knows how to pick her shots. You know, she doesn't just dart straight in. She will circle and she will go on the bike and look for good openings. You know, she has much better timing. Murata, she's too in and out. You know, she's too in and out. I saw this in the Emily Ducote fight, And Jandaroba, her striking IQ, you know, it's too high. It's too high. You know, she'll know how to pick those shots, and she knows how to time those level changes. So as she comes in, she's going to time her and just, you know, pick her apart. Boom, boom, back her up. Or as she come back her up, or she'll go in the back foot and land good strikes. That's why I feel like she won the Mackenzie Dern fight, too, because she was much more fluid with her punches, and she connected better shots, in my opinion. But, yeah, overall, good fight. From here, Verna Jandaroba, I like to see her in there with Tisha Torres, Angela Hill winner. Or, you know what would be a good fight? Amanda Ibas. That would be good. I would have to be leaning towards Verna Jandaroba early on, but that would be a good fight for both Ibas and Jandaroba. As for Kanako Murata from here, just let the arm heal, work on that jujitsu, and just overall striking and timing, and just kind of pick your battles. You know, don't just jump into the guard of these jujitsu practitioners like that, because the more and more she continues to fight like this, which she's done in the past, you know, it's going to happen over and over again. You know, that arm's going to get damaged. You're going to get submitted easy. Because even if you go in there again, like with a fighter like a Mackenzie Dern, Carla Esparza, I see all these fighters doing the same thing to Kanako Murata. You know, you just go back to the Emily Ducote fight. Emily Ducote was able to put her in like 4 or 5 armbar attempts. You know, luckily, Murata had that strength to break free of him. But yeah, she was getting put in armbar attempts. She gets put in armbars, you know, many times. She's just able to break out because of physical strength. So that's something she needs to really polish up on. Yeah, man. But from here, Verna Jandaroba, like I said, Amanda Ibas would be a good fight. Let me know, guys, in the comment section. Combo Breaker 99. I'm out. Subscribe. Peace.